Let's talk about batteries. So if we have two batteries here, one of them is larger, so it has much bigger capacity, 2200 milliamp hours, and another one is a bit smaller, so it only has 1500 milliamp hours. So if we have those two batteries connected in parallel, so effectively like this, then they eventually equal each other. So if one battery will have higher level of charge, the other battery will effectively suck this charge from this first battery, and they will both equalize each other. This bigger battery will end up charging the smaller battery. Now, if we turn the page over, same two batteries. What happens if we connect them in series? So if this battery plus is connected to minus of that battery, and then we charge those two batteries from external source, what will happen when this battery is full? So let's say this battery is full at this level here. This battery will still be up that level. And if we continue charging, this battery will be overcharged. By the time this battery will reach full capacity, this battery will be overcharged. The lithium-ion batteries do not like to be overcharged or over-discharged. So they don't like to go above 4.2 volts or below 10% of their volume. Usually this type of problems would be resolved with the use of BMS. So what actually BMS does in this case? So if we have a resistor connected to this cell, and we have FET, for example, that can connect this resistor to the ground and effectively discharge this cell until it will be equal with a smaller cell on the other side. And that's what effectively BMS does. So BMS would have a discharge circuit which will allow to discharge one of these cells. So how am I going to resolve this issue? Because I do not have a BMS. Thing I'm going to do, I'm not going to charge my cells up to the 4.2 volts. I think I'm going to charge to much safer lower level of 4.0, for example, or maybe 3.8. And that will give me a bit of a leeway on not to overcharge some of the cells. And also the other thing I will be doing is I will not be discharging them as low as 3.0. So I will be trying to discharge them down to 3.2 or 3.6 volts. The other problem I have of course cells of different chemistries and different capacities. So I have, for example, 2500 milliamp hours, I have 1400 milliamp hours, 2212 milliamp hours, and lots of other cells. So because of this, what I'm planning to do is to actually separate them into the packs and try to equalize the overall volume of the pack. And I will show you how I'm planning to do that in a minute. How do we charge a lithium-ion battery? So, if you look at this diagram, we have current on this axis and time on this axis. First, let's ignore this part. So we start charging, let's say, normally, if battery is okay, we start charging it roughly from about 2.8 volts. And in this period, we go into mode, which we called constant current. So effectively, if 100% would be 1C, so what 1C means in this case is effectively if we have a cell which is 2000 milliamp hours or two amp hours. So if we charge this cell with a 2 amp current, that will be 1C charge. Okay, so for example, if we charge it with 1C current, charging, that would be 100% of the charge rate. So we will start with the constant current mode, where we would go straight to 2 amp current, and we will keep charging this battery until at the same time the voltage will reach 4.2 volts. So voltage will reach our desired target for charging. So this blue diagram here is our voltage. So if we start charging, if we ignore this pre-charge bit for now, we start charging from 2.8 volts, our voltage will be increasing until it will reach 4.2 volts. And at this stage, we'll then go into next phase, which will be constant voltage phase. So in the constant voltage phase, we will maintain the same voltage, but the current will be slowly tapering off, and it will go taper off to fill up the cell up to maximum, and will stop charging at roughly about 10% 1C capacity. And that's where we consider our battery to be fully charged. So now we can talk about the pre-charge. So what's a pre-charge? So if for whatever reason your battery has been discharged below 2.8 volt, you can't just jump straight to 100% current. So you should really kind of bring it back to life with just charging it very, very gently with a small amount of current. And then basically this diagram shows you you roughly charge at 20% of 1C rate. And in this case, the voltage will slowly increase and will reach desired starting point for our constant current phase. Talking about pre-charge, what I really like about this charger, it's called Zanflare. So this charger is actually has this pre-charge. It has this pre-charge part built in. And if some other chargers, if you have a cell that is below 2.8 volts, the other chargers will just refuse to charge it, where this one will go into this pre-charge phase and will charge it with lower current to reach the desired voltage, and then it will charge, continue the full cycle to go into constant current and constant voltage phase. Well, let's see how I am charging the lithium-ion modules. So basically this is the example how I'm going to do that. So this is the lithium ion cell and just a holder, plus and minus. And I'm going to use the lab power supply here. The great thing about this power supply, it has a constant current and constant voltage mode. So this button is constant voltage and this button is constant current. As you can see, I already set up 4.2 volts and 1 amp current. So I don't really know what's the C rate of this cell, but if it's 2 amp hours and I'm charging with 1 amp, it will be half a C charge rate. So I think it's quite acceptable. This one is plus, so I'm just connecting the red wire, and this is the minus. And notice I still have not enabled the power. So now if I zoom in on the power supply a bit and enable the power, you can see immediately the button constant current is enabled. And what's happening is that the voltage will slowly keep increasing until it will reach 4.2 volts. So it's increasing slowly, 4.1. So I'm going to leave it recording and then maybe I will we'll speed it up later. Once it will reach 4.2 volts, it will switch to constant voltage. But then you will see the current will start to decrease and slowly will keep decreasing until I switch the power supply off. And we'll keep recording and then I will skip straight to the point where we are getting 4.2 volts. Here we go. Now we have turned on the camera again. So we reached 4.19. So at this point, we're going to switch from constant current to constant voltage mode. Now this button, constant voltage, should light up when the switch will take place. It's a bit like watching paint dry, isn't it? Yay! You can see the switch just taking place. And now we constant current switch to constant voltage and switch back to constant current. Yay! Now it's switched again. And obviously the cell is a bit sagging, but so now we are in constant voltage mode, and now you can see the current is beginning to slowly decrease and just top up this cell to the maximum. Well, I'm not gonna wait till the end. So well, that's pretty much the idea how it's supposed to work.